Welcome back, everybody, and half a day, and happy holidays to you and yours. I'm Jason Salas, and this is KUAM News Extra. Now, we know we say here a lot of the time you picked a great night to tune in, and it always is, trust me when you do, but tonight is extra special because let us go right to the wide shot, because why would you want to look at me when we have the very lovely Miss Universe Guam 2014, Brittany Mesa Bell. Brittany, half a day.
Half a day.
All right, good to see you, and good to meet you for the first time. A lot of people maybe have heard of you through social media and stuff like that because a buzz has been generated about you, but a lot of people, this is going to be their first exposure to you, so congratulations on your success.
Thank you so much. I'm really excited, and I'm excited to informally meet the rest of the people that have had a chance to get to know me.
Yeah, through the internet. YouTube's a great way to make an introduction.
So. Yeah, I guess I could do that.
Okay. So since you have won being Miss Universe Guam 2014, how has that experience been, and has it truly sunk in yet as you prepare for the larger goal?
No, I mean, it sinks in every once in a while when I'm like, oh my gosh, I'm going to Miss Universe. I'm representing my roots. This is amazing. But sometimes I'll forget that, you know, I'll forget to put my sash on because it's a dream to me. It's unreal. I didn't think I'd ever have the chance to do something like this. And it happened. It's been a whirlwind. There's so much preparation that has to come into play. And I'm really taking it seriously. So everything I do is full force. Mm-hmm. So that means I'm getting worn out very easily.
Now, we've talked to like quite a few, you know, beauty pageants and queens and princesses and what have you, like over the years in various capacities. Some of them say they feel the gravity of representing their island, their community, you know, their family, what have you, the extended family of Guam. And some say like, and you know, like the fact that I actually won hits me later. Others are, you know, like, it's like, okay, I realize I won a few days after. And then I realize just how many people are supporting me and how many I'm representing in the larger pageant and everything like that. How has it been for you?
It's been out of this world. I've cried many times just thinking about it because it hits me so deeply because, I mean, I think about all of my ancestors. I think about everything that's been built up in Guam. I think about my Nana, my Tata, and I think about all my family. And what a lot of people don't know is that there was a big split in my family from the island to the States. And by me choosing to do something like this, it's really united our family in a different way. And it made a huge mark in our family. So it means that to me. It also means more because I'm getting to represent something that's possibly going to be history depending on what happens at the pageant. We haven't had a winner from Guam. We've had someone come really close, but it's been over 30 years and we haven't placed in a long time. So that to me is a lot. And representing Guam is huge because we are the biggest island in the Marianas. And I'm also thinking about all of the other islands in the Marianas. I'm thinking about, you know, Pompeii, and I'm thinking about everyone because they don't have representatives in Saipan. So it's huge for me. It's really big.
Now, your background is actually quite interesting, and your education is very impressive because you went to Arizona State, the mighty Arizona State. So am I correct in assuming you're a Sun Devil for life?
I am a Sun Devil for life. I haven't gone anywhere else for master's, so yeah.
Will you be returning to Tempe to pursue your graduate education?
No, you know, I'll be here on Guam. I don't think I'm going to be returning to Tempe. It depends what happens.
It's a great school.
It is. It's a really good school.
And you went to a good department within a great school named after a very well-respected journalist. So tell me about that.
Yeah, I went to the Walter Cronkite School of Journalism, Mass Communications. That was huge for me. I wasn't sure which school I was going to go to. I was thinking about going to San Diego, which where a lot of my family had moved to. Mm-hmm. Or I was thinking, you know, just going to Arizona because of the Walter Cronkite School. And I'm so glad I did. They have one of the top broadcasting facilities. They have some of the most advanced equipment for us to use and learn on, and I feel very well prepared. Coming into the broadcasting world is very important to me, as I should be prepared. So that's been amazing. And I mean, I couldn't have asked for a better place because I'm also a dancer, and my college job was dancing for the MBA, which was right next to the Walter Cronkite School of Journalism.
So you had an even better viewpoint than people who spent, you know, $1,500 a game on ringside seats.
Oh, yeah. Some
courtside
people spent,
seats, I should say.
Yeah, you six were right figures there. A year sitting courtside, and I had an actual chance to be right in front of the players. And we did NBA All-Star Weekend there while I was in college. That was my second year of college. And I got to present the Olympic gold medal rings to our USA team alongside Jerry Colangelo. And I had the chance to dance in front of Jay-Z and Beyonce. It was the most amazing experience. And I even, don't tell anyone, well, they'll know. But
we this even is only went going to, like, out to about 300,000 people.
One of Michael Jordan's private parties. And we had no idea that these types of things would happen for us. You know, in college, you don't think that. But it's been amazing.
That is incredible. Okay, now, you know, I've got, like, literally a litany of questions here. I'm going to just basically, like, throw those away because we're going to go freeform here. Okay, so as a sports fan and, you know, like, as someone who appreciates the Pac-12, even back then to when it was Pac-10, you know, when you were in school, I must say, as a, again, as a lifelong Sun Devil, do you like the old logo of ASU better or the new one on the football helmet? And that's a tough question.
I mean, the new one is more edgy. You know, it's edgier. It's a lot more, I guess, like, powerful. But I like old school. I think I like the old school just because I'm more of, like, an old-fashioned type person. And I think it kind of reminds us the roots of ASU. Mm-hmm. And with the Pac-10 and now being Pac-12, that, for me, it's really important because I remember living in the dorm rooms that were affiliated with, like, the football players and the basketball players. So I would see them getting ready for the games. We'd go out and cheer for them. And even one of our fellow ASU Sun Devils went on to the NBA, James Harden, and he went to school with me.
Absolutely.
So it really means a lot to me to represent a school that dates back so far and does so well.
And to think, when you walk around on campus, you can literally walk the same steps that a national hero like Pat Tillman, the late Pat Tillman, Jake the Snake Plumber.
They're really big at our school. It's a big deal for us, and it means a lot. So I'm hoping to really represent well for my college as well. And
absolutely.
I know they're very proud that I'm here on Guam doing everything I'm doing.
And you've got a very impressive journalism background, you know, like post-graduation and everything. So tell me about some of the stories that you have covered and what you enjoy telling and everything. And how do you think you can bring that into your rapport as a beauty contestant?
It's been a really awesome journey to be able to just have that experience with broadcasting. With broadcasting, you know, you have to get out and set in the community. You have to get out there and relate to the people and do some interviews. So it's given me the ability to be really improvisational. Like, I have to be on camera, be ready to go, and that's helped me a lot. Doing the stories, I've done some just local stories within the community in Arizona. I was doing things that people were curious about, you know, new fads that were happening with weight loss and different things that were happening in the community with, like, dancing and the Phoenix Suns. I did the in-game promos for Phoenix Suns, which was fun, the item of the game on the Jumbotron. I've done a lot of different things, like web hosting for shows that were aired weekly for a lot of the small businesses that were happening. And so I did entertainment news, and all of that comes together because in the beauty world, you have to be well-rounded, and you have to understand not only the critical stories that I would report, but also those really loving family stories and what's going on in the community. Mm. So
how do you take, you know, kind of like the culture and the virtues of what you learned, like being a member of the Arizona community, and then, you know, going back to your roots and your, you know, your who you are as a Guamanian and a Chamorro and everything like that? And, and how do you plan to project those when you're up on stage, you know, again, representing Guam and showing what the best of Guam is?
Well, being Chamorro is, like, really, 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 really important to me because it's everything that I've ever grown up knowing. And the reason why is because I didn't get a chance to meet my biological father. He had passed away, but the family that I knew the whole time and the biggest implement of who I was and what my character was to be built upon was what my mother showed me, and that's through all of the Chamorro roots, which is all of this love that we have, that true Hafidé spirit, and the food and everything that we have ever had, just being Chamorro. That's what I have and always have known about. And so for me, it's important, and that's what I plan to show to everybody when I go to Miss Universe. I plan to show them how loving we are, how accepting we are, but also how strong we are, that we are to be recognized, because my mom always taught me to never give up. She was very careful about keeping the peace and making sure that she was loving to everyone, but at the same time, she was one of the most strongest women I've ever known. She still is. And I carry that with me always, and I see it everywhere I go. Because it's here on island, it's a part of who we are.
Okay, well, we got about 30 seconds, and I know you're gonna use these 30 seconds wisely being a broadcaster, but what goes on from you from here on out? What's your plan?
Well, I'm heading out to the States to go get ready because the pageant's held in Miami. It's going to broadcast live in Guam on the 26th on NBC, and I will be getting ready to go. I have my native costume I'm getting ready with, my gown, and I'll be getting my swimsuit body. I've been working out really hard for it, so I really want to push, and I will be doing everything I can, as well as being out in the community in these past I guess in these next 5 days, I'll be really pushing to make sure I say hello to everybody before I go.
All right. Well, Brittany, an absolute pleasure.
And, Thank you.
We're very honored and privileged to have you representing us.
Thank you. I'm so honored. And thank you to everybody.
And, you know, and the slightest bit of a subjective note and everything like that, the fact that you've dealt with Guam humidity plus Arizona heat, and now you're going to go compete in Miami, I think you've got the upper hand.
Thank you.
As far as it can do, your hair is going to look great.
Thank you.
You know how to get it ready.
Yeah. There's nothing like the island, though.
All right. Well, good luck.
Thank you.
All right. Stay tuned, everybody. We are back right after this. Keep on watching.